All right, so it's been a minute, but do you remember Bruise Day Tuesdays? I remember Bruise Day Tuesdays. So we've been doing some of that, and this is what's gonna happen today. So, yep, this is what's coming. Ren, brand new printing from Shadows of Innistrad. And Slugurk the Overslime. So let's dissect this that we got going on here. First of all, we got Red and 7, 5 mana, 5/5. Legendary Planeswalker. Good stuff. Plus 1. Reveal the top 4 cards of your library, put all land cards revealed this way into your hand and the rest into your graveyard. Draws lands. We like that. Syrah, put a number of land cards from your hand onto the battlefield tapped. I doubt that this will ever come up, but I guess it's an option, but I doubt we're ever gonna activate that ability. -3, create a green treefolk creature token with reach, and says these creatures' power and toughness are equal to the number of lands you control. Big dudes. Lastly, -8, return all permanent cards from your graveyard to your hand. You get an emblem with you have no maximum hand size. Pretty good. Pretty good ultimate. Draws a bunch of cards. Slugurk the Overslime. This one is an interesting one. One green blue, 3/3 trample legendary creature. Whenever a land is put into your graveyard from anywhere, put a +1/+1 counter of this. So this gets pumped off of fetch land, this gets pumped off of Sagas Dying, etc. You remove 3 +1/+1 counters from Slugurk and you can bounce into your hand. And whenever it leaves the battlefield, you can return 3 land cards from your graveyard to your hand. So you can recur your fetch lands, you can record your Urza's Sagas and stuff when this thing dies. Which is kind of a big deal. Like just like a random life from the loam. Like even if this dies, it just gives you value on the way out, which is pretty neat. So we're combining this with, like a just removal package. A couple of copies of Traverse, so we can go find our gal Titania. We can also go find Dryad. We have a Valakut package going on as well. Urza's Saga. Also, I just realized this gets pumped whenever we cycle Tranquil Thicket. That's awesome. And then the usual suspects that we see in the package that I like with Urza's Saga. Solgad, Lantern, Shadow Spear, Expedition Map. We're also backing a main deck Endurance to go alongside all Traverse. The main idea came from Dom. He was the one that suggested this shell. I just made some adjustments, which some things that I didn't like from his list, and I kind of like made some adaptations to my own liking. But this is an interesting deck. This is a very, very interesting deck. We're gonna see how it actually works out. The sideboard is it just has a little bit of everything. Some Alpine Moon, some extra removal spell against like DRC decks and whatnot. Couple of veils, Biting Needle, and Relic to go find with our saga. One interesting thing is like whether we want Relic over Solgide. The reason for playing Relic is that Relic buffs our Slugurk, which is pretty funny. Actually, that's not true. Never mind. Never mind. Never mind. For whatever reason, I thought that whenever so it's when this leaves the battlefield, but it's when the lands go into the graveyard. Okay, so never mind. Never mind. So I think Solgide's just better than Relic. Three endurances, couple of Force of Vigors, Foundation Breaker, and Fury. These, of course, we can go find with Traverse. So that's why we have those little bullets there. No idea what to expect here. This seems like another alternative to Naya Lands. So we're gonna see whether it works out. Not sure how this guy is gonna feel. So I'm kind of interested in finding out. So we're gonna find out together. If you're enjoying the content, make sure you hit the like and subscribe button, and I'll see you for number one. All right, here we go. One lander, the 29 land deck, probably not. Okay. Probably send a Traverse here. Hey, Zach, thank you. Oh, that's a dead monkey. That kind of sucks. This deck is all the rage right now. are my fetch lands? What are my thoughts on a P-Fire Unban? It's more of a why. Like, what's the upside? More than anything else. What do we gain by P-Fire existing in the format? Can we please have no dismember? No dismember. None. No dismember whatsoever. Damn it. It's like a fair word for strategies to fight Lurrus decks. That's just pretty stupid. Like, Lurrus decks fight each other. That's what they do. You don't need the P-Fire to fight Lurrus decks. Come on, man. Land. No, not that one. Where are my fetches? Well, I can't do anything, so I'm just gonna pass. Where are my fetch lands, dude? This is exactly a two-turn clock. Fuck me. Alright, I guess we lost. That was sure something. What are we doing here? We probably want Fury. Oh, this deck plays Blood Moon somehow. That's right. Which I think it's an absolute joke that this Eldrazi deck plays Blood Moon. And they play like no fixing at all. It's truly a ridiculous thing. It really is an absurd thing how they're just jamming Blood Moon in there, and they could have more fixing very easily if they wanted to, but they just don't. Like, they're only playing three Prismatic Pistas, and it's just like just play more. Like, just play four, I guess. Yeah, I don't think Ren is gonna be good. It's gonna be slow. They have a couple of wastes, but they have Prismatic Vist. Like, they don't have Prismatic Vist. They have three Prismatic Vist instead of the full playset, is what I'm saying. I think I'm keeping this hand. Tour Guide LOL, thank you for the follow. So I'm gonna fetch Triumph here, and now I'm gonna play this so I can go fetch a basic forest. Just bought a set of Ren and Seven, let's go. Nice. Grow my Slogurk, thank you very much. They have also this member? Okay, they don't. Are we serving here? No, we're not. We're serving next turn. Because my opponent can outwalk here. They probably have a breathe. No fury. It's a lot worse. That is a lot worse. I can play this. Nah. Just gonna chill here. We're gonna be taking a bunch of damage from this fury, but do I think Renan Sevis is better than Nissa who shakes the world? Considering I have a grand total of zero. Zero times that I have cast the card, I don't know. It's probably impossible for me to know. They have five ways to fix their mana, dude. They have five ways in their entire deck. They have five ways of fixing their mana for Blood Moon, and they always have it. It's ridiculous. Literally, five in the entire deck. And all of these cards become uncastable. And I've never seen the Eldrazi player not have the wastes whenever they cast Blood Moon. And I'm not saying that they shouldn't play Blood Moon. Like, they probably should. Like, the card is strong. It's just, you should play more fixing. Why is this stock just three Prismatic Vistas and two Wastes, and nobody ever thought about it? Like, nobody ever discussed, maybe we should have more fixing for that to not make our deck awkward. It's just, nope, that's it. That's what the very first person did, and nobody ever questioned it. They just copied and pasted the list. It just blows my mind. But, yeah, there we go. See you next round. Alright, round number two. Sure, let's keep this hand. And how do we want to do this? I think I want to go turn one Stomping Ground. I think this may be wrong, actually. Maybe I should be just passing with mana up to Unholy Heat, whatever they play. Green source. Ugh, brutal. Well, at least we got removal for next turn. That's nice. Is this just like spirits from a million years ago? Starting with sure that mana bases both support Blood Moon and play all the lands they require to play. Except it's not really, right? Which is my point. Like, it's so easy to fix. It's not really that big of a deal. And that's my point. Like, you can at least make it slightly better, you know? But they just don't. Like, just nobody does. Which is really confusing to me. It's crazy how humans have evolved to be just mediocre. Well, I mean, human, that's kind of the point, right? Like, humans has not evolved, and the rest of the format has. Humans has not evolved, but oh, fuck. Okay. I got caught here. So I think now I Am I supposed to still kill this? Because this is gonna trade with one of my dudes. I think we just let that go. No, we don't. We just kill this. Which is really awkward because we're gonna take a bunch of damage now, but. Now that's a 4-2. Yeah, I probably just have to pass here. We minus here with Ren. Play Ren, kill this. No, we just have to do this. Man, this is pretty rough. Because we're gonna have to get used to the commando being a thing. No cards. That's a lot. That is a lot. Okay. Let's bring the heavy hitters. Those are good. Gonna cut Rens again, gonna cut Soul Guide. And I think this is fine. Cedric had a hot take that the new Innistrad humans were so good that humans will drop Mantis Rider. Okay. I mean, it's gonna take like a second. Like, now that I know. Now that it's on my radar to play around the instant speed human, like, now, next time I play against this deck, I'm just gonna bowl the fucking dude on my main face, right? Instead of 2-for-1 in myself. It is... Like, it can only be so bad, you know what I'm saying? Now I'm just gonna play around it and it's gonna be a lot easier. Also, how the hell does my opponent ever beat this hand, right? Literally impossible for them to beat this hand. In before we lose somehow. Tom, thank you so much for the Prime sub, coming back for 20 months. Let's play that. Heat there. Put this into play tapped. Plus on my Ren. Pass the turn. Maybe Tuesday, but here every day is Wednesday. You know what's up. You know what's up. Can we draw a fetch land? We have 11 of those. We have 11 of those fetch land cards. You see, it's a lot easier now, right? It is a lot easier now. I just do everything on my main face and my opponent can never win this game. So my opponent got me because, you know, they're playing a new card that I wasn't expecting. That's not, you know, stock or whatever. And we're drawing like shit, right? Like we're not drawing cards, we're not drawing lands, our Rani is not doing anything. But we can't lose anymore because now I know to play around that stupid card. So I probably want to kill this thing. Steal no lands. Still no lands ever, apparently, but here we are. Here we are. Just out here trying to find lands. Right, that one is on my opponent, okay? That one is on my opponent. Will we get there? Will we draw one of our 11 fetch lands? Ursa Saga. That's awkward. Think we take it. I mean, I probably just have to shock here, fury this. This is so brutal, man. Kill there. I can't believe how much we whiffed. In before casting my contents, right? I can't wait. Can't wait for Kessigmal contents. The good thing is that they can't attack. Think I'm supposed to switch the Shadow Spear over here. They have zero cards in hand, so if they have Mantis Rider, we still can block it. And if they have Reflector Mage, they have to Reflector Mage this. Well, that does it. So now we send here. Opponent blocks, we're just gonna gain some life. That was pretty good endurance, actually. That was a pretty good. Maybe it's just better than this guy. Just as a surprise motherfucker blocker. This seems fine. Nope. 5 we go. Okay, this hand is good at least. So keep, and I think we're gonna bottom Titania, and we're gonna bottom... Fortist. Mantis Rider, so Rendown, which is kind of annoying. It's gonna gain 5 life, which is not nothing. The problem is that I think I'm gonna go Saga into Dryad, play Valakut, say go. So now this is locked into killing my Dryad, which means that I get to untap with Saga and do the Saga thing. You have to kill this right now. Is my opponent gonna get owned? Well, looks like they're getting owned. So, shoot there. Shoot. They should have killed the Dryad main phase, obviously. I think these are the ones that I want to kill. Oh, they're just... Okay. I'm assuming that they don't know that they could just kill the Dryad. I'm just taking 8 here. Oh, Liberator attack trigger. That's right. Okay, so I guess we have to do it right now. Yeah, I forgot that this actually triggers an attack. It's pretty good. Almost forgot. Almost forgot that this just turns into fucking Trigon Predator. I'm gonna take 4. We're gonna make a token on end step, and then we can make another token and then Shadow Spear next turn. Okay. Draw a blank. And I think I'm just gonna go squatter their Horizon Canopy. While they can't draw. We can't move the Shadow Spear around, but I don't think that's a big deal. Never mind, it is a big deal. Alright. Yeah, that's too late. That is just too late. This could have made a difference if I had drawn it last turn. But I think this turn is just too late. I'm just dead to the Mantis Rider. I can attack to bluff that I have something, to bluff that I have a bolt. That's probably my best shot. Almost. Can kill here. Sure. It just doesn't do anything. It's whatever. They have so much like random artifact and enchantment hate, which is funny. Pretty good. All right, see you next round. I think I'm keeping this hand. Looks clean enough. Island. Basic island, go. Get a basic forest, play Ren plus. We're probably gonna be a little bit too slow here. Maybe Dryad does enough to stabilize. Maybe it does. If they have outburst though and they can do it on my turn, that may be a little bit more problematic. Being on the draw here is a big deal. Can we just top deck our Soul Guide Lantern? That would be neat. Play Triad. Saga plus. It's a lot. I think we're just gonna lose here. I'm assuming that we're gonna die here. They should not give me extra land drops. They should just not get cute, just main phase this. Getting cute. Hopefully we get to punish them. So I think that their plan is gonna be to end step. Oh, but the mountain is in my hand. I'm an idiot. Well, just getting that. Rain Tribal. I think there's no reason to not attack. I think they just have outbursts, so it just doesn't matter. The question is, am I dead? I think I am. Yeah, that's definitely enough for lethal. Endurances. Relic. Veil is kind of interesting. Cut goes quarter. Cut Slogurk. This card has not felt good enough, which is unfortunate. Like, it's cute, but I don't think it's good enough. Definitely would rather be playing some Naya lands against Living End. I feel like my latest Naya lands deck list is just very, very good against all of the Cascade nonsense. Chalice is plus Teferi are no joke. Bolt better than Heat, probably. Heat has not felt good in the deck so far. It's not particularly easy for us to assemble Delirium. So I'm assuming we have not drawn Traverse yet. But I'm assuming that this is gonna be similar. I think that we should not be playing Traverse and we should not be playing Unholy Heat. So I'm already thinking about the potential changes that I would make to the deck list. I think that we should just be running bolts and stuff. Yeah. Yeah, let's go. I'm not gonna play this Rune Orb preemptively because it doesn't really make too much sense to do that. Two leagues. Depends on how long they take. I'm hoping for two. I'm hoping for two, but no guarantees because I have to go record Bobble today. Today we bobble it. I did not play the solo guy because I don't want to expose it to. Well, never mind. The good thing is that there's nothing that they can take here, right? Unless they have another grief. I think they fired off this grief a little bit too early. They should have waited until next turn. Yeah. I'm basically just saving the Traverse as a thing to pitch to this Endurance. Fetch a stomping ground. Dryad. Then we just pass. Now the question is, do I want to Endurance right now just to put pressure on? And I think I do. They can maybe cycle like one street wraith or two. I can beat one or two street wraiths. And now I'm gonna say, okay, I don't wanna shuffle their living in the back. Oh, never mind. I guess just did shuffle. Play that. We gotta draw something here. Taking the soul guide was pretty good for them. Maybe I shouldn't have run out the endurance, actually. In retrospect, maybe I got a little bit hasty there. Maybe I should have just played my dryad. Is Veil of Summer gonna do Veil of Summer things and be stuck in my hand? And not achieve anything at all? That's the Veil of Summer way. Yep, I think I'm gonna lose the game because I play the endurance when I shouldn't have. What I should have done is I should just play the dryad, and that's it. I think I just fucked it up there. I should have just played the dryad and moved on with my life. Which is hard casting Curator of Mysteries here. Shadowless Agent. Alright, yep. We're gonna lose. I'm gonna Veil, hoping that I find another Endurance, but... Endurance? Nope. I did play this game poorly. I think we're just gonna be dropping the league. I think we're just gonna be dropping the league and just making the changes. Unfortunately, I don't think the blue guy is worth it. So this guy's gonna go. Thank you, Torborg. Welcome back for the 8 months. Appreciate it. So that guy goes, with that guy going, then our mana base becomes a lot better. So now we get to play more basics, which I always enjoy. Steam Bits also goes. Red and six. Doesn't do anything. Hopefully it eats. So, is there anything I can draw here? Titania? That's the only out we have. I guess we can also traverse into Titania. That's another option. So either Titania or traverse. Those are the only two cards that matter here. Okay, I'll take my free block. Saga. I mean, the good thing is that they don't have good attacks. So maybe the Saga can do something for me. What can the Saga find? Not too much, really. Shadow Spear. Expedition map, but map doesn't do anything without the Dryad. They could have outburst, but I can't play around it, right? So I just have to block every time. That's not it. That's not it. Maybe we can win this game. If they just have nothing and we eventually stop drawing blanks. This is kind of a sick art, actually. Does this exist in paper? Oh yeah, it probably does. Just like the Fury art or the Endurance art exists. Yeah, probably does. It's pretty sweet. Right, they finally figure out that they have to attack, or they did draw the outburst. Oh, I misclicked. I wanted to make a token. Whoops. 4, 10, 12. So I should be going down to 1 here. Dryad. Interesting. So we can make a token. So now we can go get Expedition Map for Valakut. So I don't want this construct token then. So I cannot make another construct, is what I mean. We also get to gain 2 life off of this. So 1, 2, 3, play Dryad. If I make a token, play Dryad. Yeah, I can't make the token. So if they don't have Outburst, right? Because they would have probably used it otherwise. So since they don't have outburst, whoa, no, I misclicked. Oh, damn it, damn it, damn it! Oh, that's so bad. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do at all. But this is, oh, actually, this is better. Never mind, I'm a genius. Never mind, this is just so much better. Because it plays around outburst now. If they outburst, I just fetch both. Yeah, I'm awesome. Yeah, there you go. These plays around Outburst or like Brazen Borrower were a lot better. We got there. My opponent should have started attacking a little bit earlier, I think. Foundation Breaker. Yeah, none of these cards do anything. Yeah, false alarm. My play was perfect. Don't worry about it. It does feel like my opponent should have started attacking a little bit earlier. This endurance is just sick. Should I just be main decking like 3 endurances in every single one of my decks? It kind of feels like it a little bit. So this card's no good. I don't like it. This allows me to play more bolts in the main deck. Probably I want to play another Titania. Maybe we have room for one more land. I guess I have to keep this. We do have Valak a Dryad here. We kind of really have to dodge fear, grief. Grief is sort of problematic. Can we dodge grief? I guess grief and subtlety are the cards that I have to dodge. I love endurance so much. I love this card so much. It's pretty incredible, really. Oh no, they stacked their triggers properly. So they're gonna take the Shadow Spear, probably. Why did MTG think of the follow? Okay. So play this, fetch, find another forest, plus play Dryad, and I'm gonna play Saga. So what I'm gonna be able to do here, which is hilarious, is I'm gonna be, well, I mean, there's that too. But what I can do is I can just kill my own Dryad with Valakut triggers. And then the Dryad comes back. That's pretty awesome. Oh, this is just lethal. Never mind. Never mind, the opponent's just dead right now. What a card. What a card. Crazy. All right, got there. Endurance for the win. Here we are, continue fighting the fight. Trying to rescue this league. Opponent reveals Yorion. I think I'm keeping this hand. Move to five. There was a Yorion control deck that top eighted an event this past week. This gonna be like a vile deck? No. It's a basic forest deck. Abundant growth, so probably Niv. If I had to guess. Yep. Ghost Quarter of the top. Ghost Quarter off the top. Red and six. Meh, okay. Probably gonna cycle this thicket. Thicket. So thicket. That's a card. That's a pretty good way to undo mulligans. I should know. Probably just gonna get fine stompy ground here. Another dryad, don't mind if I do. Hoping to dodge, like, any removal that they use, I guess, is gonna take up their entire turn, unless they have, like, Assassin's Trophy or something. And if they spend a turn playing a Niv, I just win. I guess I don't just win, I bring them down to 3, but like any land drop just is lethal. Trophy my land! Can we find a Ren, please? So Nomneph. No, they're gonna kill it now. I think. Can we draw a Ren and 6, please? BTL. Valky. Yep. Nice traverse, nerd. Nice traverse, nerd. So we probably have to kill Omnath here. We're not looking good at all. That trophy on the Valakut was just such a massive deal. Ugh. Ugh. Also, Valky exiling, I guess, was a huge deal too. Valky exiling means that I don't have Delirium. If we can dodge a removal on the Dryad, maybe we have a shot. But if the Dryad gets killed, we're probably just dead. Oh, that's like the literal worst possible case scenario. Yeah, I'm not feeling this card. I'm not feeling this card whatsoever. It's been heinous. It's been really, really bad. So Fury seems good. Fighting Needle. And that's kind of it. Just got Traverse only because it sucks. This matchup doesn't look great. I feel comfortable in this matchup with Naya Lands, but this deck seems worse at grinding than Naya Lands. Yep. Okay, talk to me. Talk to me. Am I just naming Raiden 6 with this? Am I just naming Raiden 6 with this? I think so. Maybe they have Time Raveler, but like Time Raveler is just not worth naming. Okay. Just do this and this. Pass the turn. So next turn, we float mana with Titania, we get back Saga. And we also get to play Misty. And we force my opponent to have a... they're gonna be forced to having... Sure. Wonder if they minus. They do minus, which means that their thing just dies. So, play forest, fetch, forest, Titania, get that back, kill Tiff. So now they have to Wrath. It's not a Wrath, kiddo. Not a Wrath. Not the best time walk I've ever seen. Oh, okay. Yeah, I mean, they have to take Titania, they can't take the Ren. Because Titania, you know, just kills them straight up, so... Do they play more than one planes? I have no idea. Could not tell ya. You mean for Ghost Quarter purposes? Wow, dude. I guess that just happened. Yeah, GQ and Dem of White is kind of interesting, actually. The problem is... No, that's fine. Yeah, no. Yeah, I kind of like that. Yeah, let's do that. We're guessing here, right? Like, we just don't know. Okay. So they can have red mana. I mean, they can have a Ren Ace, is what I mean. All right. Okay, what do we got here now? So they drew these three. I think I'm supposed to plus and try to find the ballot. Yes, yes, exactly. That's why I'm supposed to plus. Pew pew. That was pretty cool. That was pretty cool. We dug 8 cards deep for a Valakut. Not bad. Pretty funny how we we named our own card with Biting Needle. And I still think that that was correct, by the way. I was running a 7. That's the very first time I cast it, and it was pretty good there, for what's worth. Ren's not so scary when he doesn't have any food. I guess I didn't fuck up here, this is fine. Big yikes for OP. I think we explore. That's perfect. Forest, make a token. So I think I make a token there, but I don't make a token here. And what we can do is float a mana, go get Needle, naming Teferi. Play Dryad, swing for 3 at Ren. Play this map for Valakut. Kill Ren. Play that. Fetch land right on time. Fetch land right on time. Uh That's hot. That is hot. I think they have Kaya's Guile. They're gonna make me sack and exile my graveyard. Which is kind of annoying, but it's fine, we got Sewer Norb. So maybe should have attacked first. Yeah, that was the mistake. I should have attacked first. I missed 3 points of damage. Opponent should be at 14. Yeah, I could have cast Big Ren instead of this. Because this kind of like guarantees that I hit the land, right? Unless they have Guile. Gonna plus first because we can find another Valakut. We don't, because I'm pretty unlucky, but now I can sack this and I can plus cycle looking for another Valakut. We don't find it, that's fine. Go face, yes, yes. Go face, attack face, fetch. Stomping ground, face, bolt you, fetch, face. Sweet. Renin 7 was not great there, but still got there. All right, last round. Probably keeping this. These cards are both bad, but it's fine. Reclaimer package. Yeah, it's not very reliable, no. So if this is a control deck, we probably can never win, right? I would imagine. Chalice for one. I guess that was a reason to traverse on one, huh? It's a little bit risque to play Saga here, but playing Saga allows me to play around counter magic very nicely. Of course, they have the feel though. How has Renin 7 been feeling? Renin 7 has been good. I like Renin 7. So the stuff that I haven't liked, but Renin 7 is amongst the things that I did like. Verdict. Okay. Ding, 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 fucking ding. Don't mind me. Just plussing my planeswalker to draw three cards. Don't mind me. Just here. I'm just here plussing my planeswalker to draw three. Don't worry about it. Do not worry about it at all. Do not worry about it whatsoever. Cryptic. Oh, Charco. El Charco. Yeah, there's this card called Chalice of the Void, which blanks all of the cards in my hand currently. Silly card. Silliness of a card. Would like to make a token. Like to make a token. I think I'm gonna get Suranorf here. Faithful Mending? Are they playing? They're not playing Reanimator. They're just randomly putting Faithful card disadvantage spells in their control card advantage deck? Is that what's going on? That seems to be what's going on. 6 mana. For the Sharkest of Typhoons. Trying to think how I'm gonna sequence this turn. I think and this chalice is destroying me. Wait a second. Does this do what I think it does? Can I just loan back 3 cards to my hand right now? Oh, wow. Yeah. Bounce it to hand. Get back three Ursa Sagas. Right, so I guess that happened. So discard the uncastables. There's the Wrath. Starting to get a feel that I may just deck myself here. With all of these random 7 activations. Opponent has seen enough! Opponent has seen enough! I mean. Alright. All right. Oh, that's right. I can endure as myself to not deck. That's sick. Right. I'm coming around to this one a little bit. I'm coming around to this little guy a little bit. Not gonna lie. Not gonna lie. I think I won the artifact destruction. Not only for the chalices, but also for the sharks. All right, Slowgurk, the overslime. You've got my attention now. I'm probably gonna try to hold the fetches for this guy now. Fine, breeding pool. See if this resolves. Flooding a little bit over here. We're definitely flooding a little bit. But even if they kill this, I get back my saga. Would like to draw three, please. Actually, that was a mistake. I should have only targeted two of those. Now I can't play Saga. Yeah, that was a pretty big fuck up actually. I should have only gotten two of these back. Got too excited. So I guess we could. That's kind of fine now. Stomping ground. I guess it's not fine. We're warming a short. Yeah, I fucked it up. I should have left one of these in the bin. So that I could have played Saga. So I just time walked myself for no reason. Get too excited about loaming things back to my hand. Baby Teff. Think we're killing this thing. Oh, come on. Let's not do this thing where I flood now. This is unfortunately gonna run into counterspell, I think. Maybe I should have held. I should have probably held. Yep, super punished for not holding the Titania there. Could have made my opponent's mana more awkward. Made a couple of bad mistakes. Oh, I should have played the Shadow Spear. What am I doing? Yeah, I could have played Ren plus Titania this turn, making my opponent mana pretty awkward. Ugh. Oh, so that was a pretty bad misplay on my part. Should know better. Should know better. Also, I guess I forgot to equip, but that's not that big of a deal. Well, they're planning on verdicting, I guess. That's a pretty big exchange for me. Rest in peace. Yeah, that turn where I played it, Titania, that's what's gonna lose me the game right now. Cause I could have put more pressure on my opponent by forcing them to hold on to stuff. Force of Vigor off the top, 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 Force of Vigor off the top. That's not a Force of Vigor. Probably gonna lose to the Sharks now. Also, I forgot to plus this. It doesn't matter. Okay, I'm over this game. We're done now. That's brutal, man. That's so brutal. I deserve to lose that game, though. I guess I'm gonna keep this hand. It's funny enough for me to want to keep it. Would some creature land be good to this deck? No. Gonna get Stomping Ground here, I think. Well, Hall of the Storm Giants would be nice. No, it wouldn't. I'd rather play Basic Island than Hall, and I'm already not playing Basic Island, so obviously I wouldn't want to play Hall. We can't crack Expedition Map here, unfortunately, because I want to find Saga, but then I want to use Veil of Summer. I'm so good at this game. Holy shit, I'm good at this game. But then I want to protect the Saga that I find with a Veil of Summer from a Spreading Seas. It's not about the cost of activation. It has nothing to do with the cost of activation. It has to do with the marginal upside being worse than, you know, just playing good cards. Aaron with the tier 1 sub. Coming back for 3 years. Jeez. Thank you so much, Aaron. So I think we go Saga here. Or we can play Ren. Get back Thicket, play this Misty, say go. I think that was a good turn to resolve Ren. Now we can start drawing two cards a turn. Get more mana than my opponent. We can start using Saga, so we don't need to throw stuff into counter magic. Just thinking about 3 years, man, that's a lot, Aaron. Just thinking about 3 years, that's a heck of a lot. One realizes that they are in desperation mode. We can make a Saga token this turn. We can make one next turn, and then we get back the Saga. Unless they have Surgical. Probably not supposed to play around Surgical, though. I could just get Biting Needle named Jason my sculptor. Yeah, let's do that. I'm probably going to try to attack it anyway. So if sequencing is actually important, I want to play this Saga first, then plus on the second Saga. That's the best way to play around Surgical there. So probably end step, we're gonna cycle Caitria Triumph here. And then we can start spitting out Construct tokens, two sagas at a time. My guy. My guy. There's no need to do this just yet, though. So I'm just gonna chill. And I'm gonna make a token to try to kill, get this Jace out of the board. So I effectively traded this Fighting Needle for one Jace Brainstorm, which seems like a fine trade. Just ran doing so much work right now. Ran doing so much work. Drawing two cards a turn. They can make a shark if they want, but it's kind of whatever. Opponent spending four mana for Cryptic when they could be just spending one, right? So silly. Imagine spending four mana for this card instead of one. Disc, disc, disc. This card is so fucked up, man. Every time I play with Ren, I'm just like, nah, the card's fine. It's just like, no, it's not. Like, it really isn't. It is not a fine card. It's not an okay card. I'd like to draw another Rusa Saga, please. Thank you. So, Tenya? There's a modern event for this weekend in my area, similar to 1K, thinking about elementals as the deck choice, maybe Naya Lands as well. Those are good choices, because, I mean, those are the choices that I would make, so... If you're proficient with both decks, they both seem like very, very good options. So they have to verdict here, and it literally does not matter, right? We just make another token extra on the step. Also, they kind of have to attack their Ren. They don't really have many good options. This game has been over for a while. But opponents fighting the fight. Yep, finally gave up. All right. I have to say that... What's the name of the card? I totally forgot the name of the card. What's the name of the card? Slogurk. So let's actually open like a new copy of this. And let's cut this Slogurks here. But let's keep them in the other list. I do like the idea of just being like straight up red green. And even in the, I guess let's look at the teamer version first. So let's look at the team reversion first. Why do you do this to me, Moto? There we go. Let's look at the team reversion first. And let's cut the fat from this list, which were the traversers were pretty bad. We want steam vents, liberating pool, and we want trial. So the traversers were very, very bad, so I'm not interested in playing that. Maybe we have to cut the fourth Valakut, and this leaves us at 30 lands, which is kind of the sweet spot. So this is what's up. Now we can cut some endurances. At least one we can cut from the main deck. I feel like I want four in the entire deck, but we can do like two main, two sideboard or something like that. And I'd rather have bolts than unholy heat. Maybe we do have to play a couple of heats just to have extra removal. So maybe cutting all the heats is too much, but we can do like five or six at most. And from the Lom, that's pretty much what Over Slime did, right? Well, yes and no, right? Yes and no, because this also can kill you. This can also just kill you straight up. So no, I don't think that we want to play Bone Crusher. That card just sucks. Trading two mana for your opponent's creature. It's too much. Maybe we can play 29 lands. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 fetchables. The combo with Surinor is no joke. This also allows me for blue cards in the sideboard. Titania looked insane whenever we drew her. This is an interesting shell. Maybe this is just what needs to happen in order to clean up the deck list. And we can have Teemo Wrens, and we can have just red-green Wrens. And then John Wrens, which was my original list. This was my original list. This one may be a little bit too clunky though. Maybe just doing dryad stuff is just doing dryad things is just better than doing assault loam things. Also, Titania feels like too bad not to play. So maybe this was just like an idea, and it's just not as good at this as this idea. My The concept was that I don't need to put Valakuts in my deck if I'm playing a Seismic Assault. So that makes the mana a lot easier to work out. Cause you just play like a bunch of, I mean it is triple green though, a triple red. I do like this decklist a lot though. So this one goes with four Valakuts. We have like a bunch of green sources. We have some Unholy Heats. I like that we have access to a bunch of basics. I really, really like how many basics we get to play in this deck list. Assault probably better than the dudes. Not really in a prismatic ending metagame, right? Also, dealing 2 is not as good as dealing 3. GGG is easier than red, red, red. Oh, yeah, 100%. 100%. You're talking about like the Ayula something, right? You're talking about the bear producing card. Yeah, obviously this would be a lot easier to make happen. But creating 2/2s is just so much worse than just making just, you know, shocks. Infinite shocks. Okay, so let's think for a little bit. If we were playing against rhinos, we would probably die. If we're playing against Murktide, maybe the endurances carry us enough that we may have a reasonable matchup. If we were playing against, I'm just thinking about like the top decks in the metagame, right? If we're playing against Hammer could be pretty rough. Yeah, Hammer would definitely be pretty rough. What else? Leaving End. With triple main deck endurance, maybe Leaving End is a little bit more manageable, and Soul Guide Lantern. On a bunch more stuff in the sideboard. So Leaving End could be a little bit more manageable. I'm kind of scared of Murktide though. I'm not so scared of Murktide with Nihilands because we're just playing Prismatic Ending, right? Like that just answers so many questions, like the Blood Moons in the both cyber the games and shit. Engineered explosives. Throw a couple of those in the sideboard. Maybe play another relic in place of endurance. Three endurances seems fine. I mean, we could technically play the fourth endurance in the main deck. And just say fuck it, right? I guess that instead of, we probably need another stomping ground. I probably want at least 3 stomping ground, maybe even 4 actually. So maybe this ghost quarter has to go there. I could just play a Khetri Triumph for engineered explosives purposes. It's a lot of ETB tap lands though. Let's see how many we have. Maybe we got enough. We got 23 ETB untapped. 23 ETB untapped and 7 ETB tapped. Which we can kind of sequence. Hopefully. good way. Kind of not feeling the fourth Valakut. I always dislike the fourth Valakut in this style deck. They just fix your mana for a color that you don't care about, and they are like such clunkers earlier in the game. What decks do you lose to if you don't have Chalice on one game one? You don't really auto win against anything with Chalice on one. It's a good card, but it's not like an auto win against any deck. Like, there's no more Blue Red Prowess anymore, right? Blue Red Prowess was a deck where Chalice on one game one was sort of an auto win. Or a little bit closer to an auto win. But like the DRC Ragavan decks, they have ways to work around the Chalice. And a lot of them just play Prismatic Ending. So no, Chalice is still a great card. Like, I still think the Chalice is just nuts. But this one, like, we could be playing this as a Chalice deck, but if we're doing that, then why don't we just play Nine Lands? I think we have the tools to be competent against the combo decks with our Chalice. Maybe the board needs it. Sure. Yeah, that's possible. That's possible. We did beat Living in this league, though. Maybe throws three of those bad boys in there. Something like this. And this is a clean swap, you know, bolts for chalices and vice versa for games 2 and 3. Is 3 World Wars a cyber slot? No, it's not. It is not. This is cool though. I like this deck a lot. This seems like a fine starting point for the following league, which is not going to be today, because I have to go record Nisha's Bubble, but it's going to be probably tomorrow, actually. But yeah, that's going to be it for this league. Kind of dig this deck. I'm going to continue working on it in the foreseeable future. But hopefully you enjoyed this league. If you did, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.